jump off on the back. I just got all the tracks in my lap, got a nod in the head. Nip told me this a marathon. I'ma keep running laps on you niggas shooting more shit, just paramount. I know Victoria's Secret and not the one to own Victoria's Secret. I'm not about the one your mama just keep it. One night she gave me 20,000 to be the last chicken, but baby allow me to keep it. With that being said, with that being said, close mouths don't get fed. With that being said,
oh my bad.
Still play it. Only scared of God in the feds. Niggas be dead.
Crazy when a nigga bounce low.
With that being said, yeah. With that being said, yeah. Closed mouths don't get fed, yeah. With that being said, yeah. Can I please have some money?
Money.
Follow by pussy and head.
Pussy and head.
Can I please have some money?
Money.
Follow by pussy and
pussy
head.
And head.
Y'all niggas know what the fuck going on, nigga. CDB, cross the boss, man. Peasy World.
Sure you was there on time, so you headed over there right now.
There you go.
We gonna bounce
there
this
go.
Song.
We gonna
bounce
this
song.
We gonna
bounce this song. I don't trust shit, got me moving with this Glock. Niggas hate on niggas, got me moving like a Nazi. All I see is red, got me moving like a Taki. Play with me, you dead, you won't hesitate to pop. Rally out of traffic, you can catch me with my niggas. Linking up with Jizzle, now I'm jugging off a jigger. Niggas with my ex, think I love her and I miss her. You can have it if you get a bitch, please, wrong nigga. Bitch, I'm in that Maybach, gotta swung it off the lot. You niggas know it's me, cause I be standing on the top. I just made 100, I'ma spend it on a watch. I'ma bust it down, make a offer you to watch. Praying for my ops like God, put them up. Let them live a little, boy, niggas send them up. When they in the house, all they talk about is us. Got a little money, now the niggas think they up. I can't make this shit up, nigga, be honest. Way before Giannis, a nigga had bucks. This type shit right here, too timeless.
Let's give it to the generation now.
conversation.
Way back Friday, man.
D Cross, man. I know you should be used to this.
Motherfucking Maybach, man.
I need niggas grew up on me.
Watch the snow fall with a snow bunny. Frankly, got me thinking about my money. Hello, what's up? What you want from me? Before you called, you knew you wasn't gonna get dough from me. Funny how my dad put the gold in my mom's. Funny how we left and I grew up LeBron. Funny how I wish I can call up LeBron. So PZ say what's up when he see Kobe Bryant.
DJ Drama, fuck these niggas up.
Watch the snow fall with a snow bunny. Frankly, got me thinking about more money. Hello, what's up? What you want from me? Before you called, you knew you wasn't gonna get dough from me. Funny how my dad put the gold in my mom. Funny how we left and I grew up LeBron. Funny how I wish I can call up LeBron. So PZ say what's up when DC Kobe Bryant. The first rapper out my city with a million plus. You ain't gotta see the cash, nigga. Add me up. I got no options, just my homies that be mad as fuck.
You ain't gotta see the cash, nigga.
This Audemars Piguet like spaghetti, ain't it? Floor seat fights watching Devin, ain't it? Being broke was the rule, but they say money changed me. Yeah.
So Cross said I had to come back to Vegas.
Yeah, man.
Let that ride,
man. We off the strip, though. Don't follow this path and get stripped, though.
Yo, what's up, man?
My nigga PZ gone.
I'm about to bounce the truck, man.
So one last time, I'm gonna take you to his world. Cross. Trauma.
They killed Christ. I'm like, yikes, he was trying to help. Keep me a pipe, some that a bite on my designer belt. I was on bills for 5 years, now I'm sober, nigga. Either I'm tweaking or I'm really starting to notice, niggas. Hey, I don't owe no nigga. I'm toasting up, just me and Steed. I'm screaming, yellow nigga.
That bitch gon' bounce,
yeah. I still got
that
security.
Bitch bounce.
And they gon' fight.
Say that bitch bounce, man. That motherfucker bounce, man.
So all my future prospects, I hope you mirror me.
That ain't nothing.
Might move slow, but I don't suffer from progression. Might cry out of nowhere, cause I suffer from depression. Hate learning lessons, cause we learn
yeah,
what I'm
weapons. Bounce, man.
Can't tell a soul, so I'm dealing with confessions. It's
real. Quality street.
We outside interview time, man.
Interview time, baby. And this is just the intro.
Yeah, man.
Okay, I got a confession. I
ain't never seen no
way. Now, outside of these mixtapes, I'm actually quite quiet and laid back. When I get on here, oh, I come to talk that talk.
I'm dealing with my confessions. Real.
Amen. This is Peasy's world. DJ Drama.
Stuck. I spent like 60 on this watch. How could I not lift it up? Yeah, I'm from a city where they focus on the strip, and all the hoods are far from that. Can I please borrow some chips when Cali niggas said I feel hard bleeding, niggas think it's sweet. It's been a minute. We let it die down, cause if you put a cat in the corner, it's gonna scratch your eyes.
Caesar.
Yeah,
I'm going to the food court and I'm coming back out.
Man.
Washed, yeah, man. I wish we
started. Dirty. I'm getting a wash today.
You don't get a ticket?
See how they know me over here, man.
Man, I bet they do.
LA's the store. They know me, man.
Man, exclusive, man.
We're going to do this interview right here.
All right,
we're going to park that.
put me on the spot right here. Why ain't even got talent? And they so used to me being with a car full of females. Like,
right.
Nah,
just me and
brother.
Yeah. Real shit. Caesar's Palace. Steve,
they don't even want me to get my ballet. They don't want me to get my ballet.
That type of shit.
They already know.
Oh my God.
That's how it's supposed to be, man.
Nah, real shit. Right.
And this is what they don't like. They don't like that a nigga be kind of like, you know, but I can tell everybody I'm a battle rap. Like, everything about me is competitive. You know what I mean? And what is competitive to be better than myself.
Right.
Not better than nobody else. You know what
right,
I'm saying?
Right.
Like, I got OGs that came up showing me how to, you feel me? So
right, 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 right. I got two other iPhones in my bag, so all they gotta do is set those two up on just record.
Right, right.
Put that shit to YouTube. And I'm gonna make sure I get a photo and shit. Yeah. Come to the radio station too.
Yep. Yeah, we gotta do both.
Hell yeah. Me, but I definitely appreciate this this one right here, man.
Oh yeah, we gonna go.
Yeah. I was talking to a friend today, and he was saying you gonna look back 2-3 years, you gonna look at all them little interviews.
Yeah.
But the ones that like, oh shit, I interviewed Nino Brown this year. I interviewed Monroe Flo from TFM.
Okay.
He on the same track with you and Landlord. I sent him that track too.
Okay.
He'll be sending it back to me in a couple of days.
My should be done.
About 2-3 days.
Yeah. I got studio
Saturday. Yeah, everything is just, you should know, bro, off being in the music and believing in knowing that anything's possible.
Yep.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Nigga, I mean, shit, I'm hearing, I heard Skeet's story.
Yep.
I watched Skeet on YouTube telling the story. Yeah, sleeping in the bed. Oh,
yeah.
Come on, bro.
Yeah.
That's real, bro. Yeah. And if, you know what I'm saying? For your life to turn around like that, that's big.
Yeah, bro, that shit was crazy. I ain't gonna lie, like. But it was more so, like, let me explain it to you.
Got a real star with me, man. Vegas on D Cross.
Yo, you know what's going on.
You know what I'm saying? Man. Representing, man, Northtown.
North Las Vegas.
You know what
Vegas,
I'm saying, man? Real shit, bust down.
Oh, man, we look.
Hey, man. Only Vegas rapper I know in Vegas with a Maybach truck.
The Maybach truck. Literally, man. For that matter, shit. It's me and Floyd, for real.
Yeah.
You know, me and Floyd, for real.
And you 31?
31, yeah.
I got you by 10 years, bro.
Oh, man, see, but that don't matter, though. You know
I know. I still look good. Don't get me wrong. And it's the part of me being safe and feeling good in my skin. That's and good. Knowing that. Not hating on you or anything else.
That'd be the number one problem.
Right. I still live a nice life, and I ain't got to hate on you. You feel me? That's what it got to be like. Other people got to understand that, like, okay, still respect the man.
Right.
How did you get it, though? You feel me?
Man.
Like,
oh, nah, we
alone, bro. It's really on the sense of like, how did you get it? But then really, not even just get it, bro, but like, no one used to bust their ass, though.
I know,
like,
that's
like,
the feeling.
Knowing,
but see,
like,
but see, my thing is, when I get to buying shit like that, bro, it be for like, I take my shit on my ass.
You're in the pool part, bro.
Well, I'm about to knock me a little situation. You know what I'm saying? Like, they don't never be for the niggas or like, I'm gonna kill these niggas. No, I start getting hyped about the shit when everybody else do.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Because initially it be for, I'm about to swing this bitch down to Collins in Miami and other spot. I'm about to go to LA, go to Craig's and eat what Kim Kardashian them eat.
Right.
Pull up
right.
in a suit, jump out. Like, I be thinking like that. But for the city, it's like,
I don't be trying to put up like no fucking city. Nah, they know I'm coming like this. They just
right.
Niggas who don't want. It be the niggas who ain't coming with their skin that's only mad. But then it's more love. Like I keep telling me, I see the posts on Facebook. They be, oh man, niggas stay hate.
All right. But my thing is, though, bro, just even though, like...
You want me to fall off, but I'm still on. I got that. That's coming on to Do It Like Wayne, bro. Do It Like Wayne out next month. You about to say what?
Even with the music,
yeah.
They want to hate on you and want to just say, well, you know... But
yeah,
you know what I mean.
And say it. I know what you about to say.
Yeah, they'll say, well, he ain't get that for music, or not even just for music, but the whole simple fact that it's like, damn, it's all in your face, man. I don't see how people really deny it though, bro.
Because
it's like
they say I ain't getting it for music, but what do they really know? I post all my stats, like.
So you upload your own music, everything.
Just a regular burger.
Classic,
yeah, that's cool.
Medium or well done?
Well done,
please.
Any fries?
Huh?
Medium or
well done?
Well done, please.
Any fries? Yeah,
make
it two of them. Two of them. Let me get two. I got
any
fries? Yeah,
fries,
all two. Come on.
Put
some water.
Yeah.
Anything else?
Yeah.
$60.62.
No, so, what you say, buddy? That's gonna be your anthem? No, it's coming out. Do It Like Wayne next month.
I think you should take my phone. I'll take your phone for now.
Man,
I'm taking over D-Paul's phone, man.
Yeah, man.
Y'all ain't even just that, man. I'm just here to really congratulate him.
Thank you.
To be a busy man, take his time out of the day to really have a big, man.
20, 35, 7, 8, 9, 38 cents.
Next one
is gonna be off. You're gonna pick it up on
your left side. All right.
Have a good day. Thank you. You too. Hey, exclusive interview, man.
Yes, sir.
It's different, man.
Oh, damn, I was just about to go there. Okay, it's cool. Y'all go ahead. Nah, it's good, right? Nah, we good. We good. Yeah, we go right here. Yeah, yeah. Thank you. All right, we wait. What's going on with y'all, man? We about to do this interview, man. Damn. I'm gonna bag somebody bitch on a bar, let me see if I can do it. Do I got the juice, y'all? Can I bag somebody bitch on live? Man, we're gonna be outside, really outside though. You know,
gonna get this shit in,
yeah,
really just let these people see that on an everyday life that these people don't even know that who we are,
yeah because this is the thing, it's really real. Like, one thing I'm gonna say about the music is no cap. Like, whether you wanna hate or believe it or say whatever you wanna say, the music ain't no cap, and that bitch is thick as hell. Come on. Hold on, hold this.
Man, we doing an exclusive interview from the Maybach truck, man. We're grabbing something to eat, chopping it up. Really just seeing what it's like to be in the shoes on an everyday basis, man. You know? I wonder what it's like on an everyday. Cause shit. I wonder what it's like to be in your shoes. I bet you a bunch of people wonder what it's like to be in your shoes on an everyday basis, bro.
My shoes, I ain't gonna lie, it's difficult as fuck though, like. Like, this shit just look good. It's very stressful, though. I ain't gonna lie. Like,
you say it just look good.
It just look good. I mean,
to the outsider looking in, I'd rather look good. What do you mean look good?
Nah, but it's like I say, like, when you in a position, first of all, like, having being the most talked about rapper out the city, out in other cities, and not trying, like I said, when I say something, it's not because I'm trying to be cocky. It just is what it is. Right now, the PZ world is crazy. So at this particular moment, being the most talked about nigga, for real, when it comes to the music, because when we talk about the, when we talk about the who having this shit for real, like, I don't think there's no other conversation. So, you know what I mean? And that's just not me trying to, like I said, once again, if niggas can take what I'm saying with a grain of salt and not like...
No, but I ain't not trying to cut you off, but this is a competition. It's still a competitive sport.
Yeah.
If, like I was telling my girl the other day, I was like, certain niggas, they can't beat me in certain shit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
I know you can't. Sure. You know what I mean? Sure. But as far as the game, you got it, bro.
Yeah.
On God. I ain't seen no other young nigga ball as hard as you. At this age,
yeah. I mean, so what it was for me was like let me, and I'm gonna say something like, I think niggas know they can't fuck with me when it comes to this, these assets.
Yeah.
But then, so they try to take the music approach, and it's like, bro, I rap better than everybody. Like, that's just how I'm supposed to feel.
Right.
Whether nigga believe it or not.
Right.
And I've been, most of the niggas who claiming they competition, y'all watch me do it. I've been doing this since 16 on YouTube.
Right.
If you watch me do it and watch other niggas like Landlord and certain other niggas do it,
right,
for that long, and the niggas before us, like, I don't get why people so in competition with our peers. We all from the same city.
Right.
And that's what I, niggas be like, oh, the city don't fuck with me. The city fucks with me. I can't say the city don't fuck with me.
Right.
I say the rappers from the city don't fuck with me.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
That's crazy.
But niggas, I've been in jail with niggas from Donna. I've been in jail. Lil Donna, I was in jail with Lil Donna. I was in jail with Gershon niggas. All of that. Other side niggas, don't matter.
Right.
If that was the case, if a nigga really hated me, how they saying they, you know, how most rappers try to proclaim that they hated,
right,
niggas be on that with you. When they see me, they be like, what's up, bro? And every time I get the same energy back, what's up, my nigga?
Right.
You feel
right,
me?
Right,
because
right.
It's just a regular nigga with some money, bro. Like, they ain't nothing new. I see that shit all the time. So, but with the music, I'm very competitive with it. Like, if you listen to PZ World, ain't nobody else project sounded like that.
Nah, it ain't. It's not.
And then you got niggas with smut and dirt on their name trying to speak real nigga shit like,
right,
I have no smut on my name, no dirt on my name, no goofy right. shit on my name.
Right.
And I didn't, and I don't, I'm not trying to sound like nobody. I'm not worried about no other nigga. I embrace niggas. You hit me, you said pull up, I pulled up.
Right.
You said Maybach truck, okay, cool. I wish I would have cleaned it for you.
Yeah, nah, I feel you, but you gotta understand how how they envy other people alike
for
so
sure.
much nowadays. You know what I mean?
For sure.
It's just like keeping up with the Kardashians.
Yeah.
Keeping up with King. Keeping up with D Cross.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It ain't. I can't. I'm not gonna say I'm trying to try because I'm gonna stay in my lane.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? I'm happy with my little shit that's here.
But you still nigga. Coming in this bitch? This
my Cartier and this my Petite. You feel me?
Wow.
that's where I'm at though.
Yeah.
I'm happy with that though.
Yeah,
you know what I'm
yeah.
saying? And I think, like you say, that's where the hate come in at.
Yeah.
Niggas don't even know you.
Yeah, I don't know. You. Let me tell you something. I'm gonna be honest. I've been out of touch with the streets for real for at least about 5-6 years. So when niggas from the streets be speaking on me, I don't be knowing niggas. You know what right. I'm saying? Like, you see where I told you to meet me at? On the strip. Like, I don't right. be in no hood politics like that.
Man, real shit.
And this is for the young niggas watching me that feel like they gotta go be in their hood and do that. I did that already. I got 7 videos in my hood with right. all my homies. Like,
right.
I love my hood. Shout out to my hood. But I'm saying, right. like, you don't have to necessarily do that to be that nigga.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Nah, facts.
So, most of my niggas who speak on my name, I don't pay attention to that type of shit, but if I do, I go look and I'll be like, what should I speak on me too if I was this nigga? You know what I'm saying?
Right. Nah, real shit.
So,
bro,
I
mean, even when I say when it comes to the music, you got a lot of niggas bleep.
My dog, appreciate that.
You got a lot of people beat, bro, with style, with
yeah.
class.
Yeah.
You a nigga, but you still got class, though.
I ain't gonna lie, I was raised good, though. Y'all understand, I was raised a Jehovah's Witness. You know what I'm saying? Like, I was in the hood, but I had to be in the house before 8 o'clock. So I am a hood nigga. But at the same time, I was raised
with class with, in the hood. I'm Cheyenne Point. On the west side.
You said Cheyenne Point.
I'm a Cheyenne Point baby.
Yeah.
That's my stomping ground.
Man.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So my mama is Gladys Cross. Like, my mama know Icy Jones' mama. She just told me that. I didn't even know she knew Icy Jones' mama. That's she sent me a picture of them from school. You know what I mean? And just a lot of other shit niggas don't know. But I'm more one of them niggas that when you see me, I'm polite and I'm a politic with you.
Right.
I ain't got to prove all that other shit. And that's what I'm trying to tell niggas now. Niggas don't need to do that. I was locked up for 34 robbery cases. I got dropped down to 17. Rest in peace, my nigga there.
Right,
like,
right.
It's a lot of shit niggas don't know about me, but I don't care.
Right.
Just know what I want you to know. Know that I'm getting money. Know that I can rap real good. And know that I'm going on another tour. No Peasy World out. Hold on, let me get this motherfucker boo.
Man, so all y'all that's just tapping in, man, up here with D-Cross at the Bellagio, doing an interview live from the Maybach 2021. Peasy World just dropped 625 this month on my birthday. Peasy World out. Vegas music is on the rise, man. Peasy World out right now, man. Live exclusive interview, man. From the Peasy World.
Peasy World
my,
out.
Hey, my homeboy right here, Tonio, one of them. My homeboy Tonio.
Who's that? Who's
that?
Right here.
Right here? Yeah. I told him who you were. As a man type shit. Hey, what up, brother?
Interview, nigga. I ain't want to
just. Yeah. I appreciate you, man. D-Cross. That's my homeboy Tonio. Yeah, man.
I feel like I've seen you before.
He be moving around.
I've seen him, yeah. I feel like I
know. Yeah, he be moving around. You wanna walk up there with us?
Oh,
where'd you park at?
I'm in I have parked in the back.
Oh, you parked in the back?
Google real quick.
Okay, so we're in the front part of the ballet. Now this is really, really good. Cause it's like helping a nigga break out of his shell of doing the organic.
Yeah, for
you
sure.
You know what I'm saying? Cause nigga gotta do more of that because of the content. And then if you see, like you watch YouTube, you see the dude on South Beach doing the diamond testing?
Yeah. Nigga diamond test me shit,
right? Right. But the point in case is, being out here, did you know that Vegas had a music artist? Did you know that Vegas had a music scene? Asking these people this.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So, and getting the shit on YouTube, the content of it. Building it up. Did you know that Vegas had a rapper named D-Cross? With DJ Drummer? Nah, real shit, bro.
It depends.
Nah.
I'm just trying to keep my, like I was telling bro, I'm like, bro, I'm just trying to like, see, when I look at it, I've been around the world three times on tour, so it's like, I went from trying to find some exercise to like, being like, man, I need to get my name out. And I think what's wrong with the city is, it's too busy trying to compete. I don't want to kill nobody out here, dog. That shit, damn. You don't want to do that. Because at that point, now I'm stuck in the same maze of the mindset of a nigga that's right. From this motherfucker.
Nah, real shit. When it's a whole world out there.
Yeah.
Nah, real shit. This nigga stay out of town. Every time I talk to him, he's somewhere. Like, he's moving around.
You got to move, my nigga. And that's the only thing with it, my
nigga.
You
got to shape.
I mean, yeah,
this ain't where it's at. Especially for niggas that's been here for so long,
yeah.
My nigga, you know what I mean?
It's your comfortable. I can tell you gotta get uncomfortable. Nigga think I'm 80% out the scene. Like, I'm here because of my kids. Like,
right. Show me some shit, nigga, I ain't never seen before. Right.
What's up, my boy, man? How you doing?
I got the live interview, man.
I don't put that plate on that motherfucker.
For sure. Oh, no, I got you. Oh, no, that's just what I ain't gonna do.
You know what I'm saying? They gonna move real quick.
Where you park at? You got it with you right now?
Fuck
I trust you won't scratch that car because your car is more important than any one of these.
My car boy's been the right one to tell
you. Live exclusive interview right now with D Cross.
Hey, shit, man.
On the strip.
He's hot. I like him.
Oh, and this motherfucker bouncing, bro.
This motherfucker, man.
Oh, God.
We all going back to Bellagio?
No, we finna go on top.
On top?
Yeah.
Which one, okay?
Yeah, if you want to, or if you want to just...
You know,
all right.
You know.
Okay, I feel you. No, I feel you.
In the back, fool.
Yeah.
In the back, fool.
Me?
Yeah.
All right.
That motherfucker.
Man, this motherfucker, nigga.
It's like...
Yeah.
That motherfucker is nasty, man.
This shit.
That nigga is nasty, bro.
It's like a motherfucking jet.
They got jet seats. Bro, you fucking
them
right here, bro.
I like to see the shit
about nigga. Let me get this up.
First nigga in the city with the Maybach truck, nigga, say it again. My young niggas like
to talk this shit right here, bro.
Niggas yelling out, cross rap. We ain't about to let you cross a rap. Stop your ass up in the building. Fuck around and shoot your car back. First nigga in the city with the Maybach truck. Nigga, say it again. My young niggas like when I'm talking to this fly shit. They like playing again. Niggas shelling out, cross a rap. We ain't about to let you cross a rap. We gon' stop your ass up in the building.
My nigga, just to show you that a nigga was fucking with you too. This my Apple Music, my nigga.
Oh, my nigga, Ben has the shit, sir.
Yeah,
sir.
Tough,
appreciate
nigga.
That, dog.
Yeah,
I ain't gonna lie. Hey, thank you, my nigga. That's hard.
Yeah, yeah.
That's hard. Most niggas don't be having this shit on the shit.
My nigga, I really fucks with you. If you hard, you hard.
My
you
nigga.
If you suck.
That's what it is. Feel that. Gang said he been having it.
Shit is crazy,
man. Look, I hope I pray I can make it to 41. That's
man,
the thing.
I see you get there easy. What was one of the hardest things for you, really, bro, to give up to get what you got now?
I like these questions. Nobody asked me shit like this.
Real shit, bro.
One of the hardest things I had to give up. I lost a lot of friends, man.
Yeah.
I lost a lot of friends, like, it's damn near borderline depressing.
Yeah.
It's fake love.
You said fake love?
Fake love come when you got a plan and you focus. You know what I mean? So,
that shit right. Shit, I'm not sure if you can set it up. I'm stand in my
bag.
While you left it?
Yep, in the truck, my truck.
Okay. What was fake love, man? I mean, I couldn't have no love, actually. You gotta
love in your heart.
Can't have no love in your heart. I mean, you can have loyalty.
Yeah.
But, you know, a nigga couldn't do the love in the heart type vibe because that shit always put you find yourself putting yourself second too much.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So put yourself second too much, then niggas won't put you first.
So speaking of real brother?
Blood brother, I got four brothers. Four blood brothers, you know? Cool to me, fine. See my blood brother. Same mom, different dad.
Mm-hmm. Y'all, Kyle, I know it gotta be a lot of hate. Mm-hmm. I say that because of the separation that you have from other people. You created a gap. The other motherfuckers, they gotta come up here.
Yeah.
You can't come back down there.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It ain't no way you can go back down.
Uh-uh.
Not when you created the gap.
Right.
From a man's point of view, you're doing better than niggas my age.
Right.
I'm 41, you're 31.
Right.
I got some jewels, I got some shit, don't get me wrong.
Right.
What they say, the bigger the risk, the bigger the reward.
Absolutely.
And bro, just even the Maybach truck in itself. Points up.
Right.
From having a Maybach truck. But you got what the real rappers got.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, and you know what sucked? Because rappers in the city be like, damn, did y'all see what's the name? I've watched niggas say, did y'all see this nigga grab this car? Then when I do it, it's like nothing.
That's crazy.
You know what I mean? So, I mean, but the Maybach truck, yeah. I mean, the cars and shit, that shit's cool. All right.
10 True just tapped in. What it do, 10?
Yeah, that shit's cool. I ain't gonna lie. I like it, but it's not my ultimate goal. You know, I'm scared to be famous. I really don't want to be famous, bro.
Really?
I ain't gonna lie. Because it's already hard for me to handle this fame.
Yeah.
Like, if you see this bitch in traffic, you know it's either me or my chick.
Yeah.
It's one on one.
Right.
So in having to maneuver a certain way, having to pull when I'm gonna bring it out, when I'm gonna leave it tucked in.
Right.
That go from anybody. Not no ops. I don't have ops. Right. Like niggas be like, oh, he moving freely. I don't have ops. I don't even know what that shit is for real.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I got niggas who are jealous of me and envious of me.
Because of materialistic.
Because of material shit. But me physically having done something to somebody to make them hate me, nah, I'm got no ops.
Yeah.
Maybe when I was 17, that was hella long ago.
Right.
So
you really on some man shit, taking care of your kids and really staying out the way.
Yeah.
Versus the niggas that saying they stand out the way and they always in the way.
Yeah.
Every time, you always see them out though. You know, it's on their gram, it's everywhere.
Yeah.
You said something, bro. It's already hard enough dealing with this thing.
Yeah.
That's big, bro.
It is.
Because
tough.
Like you say, damn, that shit can cause anxiety. That shit can cause a lot of other stress that's not needed. I heard you were saying that you was gonna put the truck away. Put it up because of the negative effect of it, in a sense. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And I say, well, man, at least let me interview you first in that motherfucker before you put it up. You know what I mean? Because I can understand where you're coming from, because peace is something that motherfuckers can't buy.
Oh,
you can't buy peace, bro. You can't buy peace, and you can't buy happiness.
Yeah.
And you can't buy love.
No.
Money can make you miserable, too.
Listen, dude, because you gotta understand, like, for me, money made moments better. Like, the moments that I get. Like when I right. pull up and I'm in the valet, like we right here.
Man, that's big. That's big.
And I like bounce that. It, but the memory of like it is not the same as family or like not having it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? When you pull up somewhere, the spotlight's automatically on you. Niggas right. think, oh, you trying to outshine them. Like, nah, bro, I just right. pulled up because y'all wanted me to pull up or I wanted to come here.
Right.
When you don't got it, you can move a little bit more freely. I'm not going to even say, because I know niggas with money that don't have fame.
Right.
I think it's just the fame part of it. The rapping part amplifies it and makes it that much harder to move discreetly or to not want to. Sometimes I don't want to be known. Sometimes I don't want to hang out. Sometimes I don't. I just want to pull up somewhere and don't have to have. I got my own security.
Right.
Sometimes I don't want them to pull up with me. You know what I'm saying? So it's just like, I don't know, bro. It's a gift and a curse.
Yeah, man. Man, I'm right now. It's a blessing right now because we in here eating Bob's Burger, man. Bobby's
good.
Right here on the strip, man. On a Friday in Las Vegas.
Yeah.
We outside, like mm-hmm. really outside, listening to
Peasy World,
man. Mm-hmm. To dedicate a whole album to somebody, man. That means a lot.
Yeah.
What? I heard you mention his name. I've heard you. I watched every interview you had from Room Service Radio.
Right.
High C with Icy Jones, Cold Seven. I watched all of them because I knew what I didn't want to ask you. Mm. I wanted to make sure I don't ask the same questions. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I'm like, man, I gotta really get the realness out of this dude, a different side, because it's like people will see you on TV.
Yeah.
Or the radio station, and then it looked like it's scripted and shit.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like, he gotta act like this. He gotta do like this. Now, it's a Friday. I got on my V-neck.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? This shit gonna go to IGTV. It's gonna be on YouTube.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And then I got another camera going. But it's the whole part of, man, that you exist, man.
Yeah.
I thank God that you exist.
Thank you, brother.
For your existence, man. For real, though. Because it's like,
for real.
What would it be like if you didn't exist?
I don't know. I mean, thank God I am.
Nah, real shit. I'm so glad you're here, bro. In so many different ways, because it's like, you inspire me. You 31, you got me about 10 years, bro.
Yeah.
And you inspire me so much, and it ain't got to be a materialistic thing, bro. It's just the fact that you got discipline.
Yeah, I mean.
And I came and say a young nigga. To me, you a man, a grown ass man.
Yeah, for sure.
You feel me? I see you taking care of your kids. I watch you on Instagram. I see the shit, bro.
I think for me, mostly, I don't want to be known as the average nigga when it comes to being a man. Like the tough narrative nowadays is so oversaturated. Excuses are oversaturated. I feel as if, my big mama called me and be like, hey, I need you to do that, this, that, and the third. And, you know, and I'll be like, okay, babe, mom. Okay. And then when you start to develop a relationship of just understanding, even though it's not your job to do whatever somebody's calling you, once you start to take on more weight, you get more blessings. I swear to God.
I never looked at it like that.
I take on so much weight, bro, off these cameras. And God, I don't know if he just, like, I'm about to get a, like, exclusive, like this exclusive part, like I'm about to get another Maybach and keep this Maybach. Cause I told, when I posted that, the nigga at Mercedes sent me another one. He said, now I'm gonna get you this one too. And then I don't know if y'all seen the DMs I posted for my chick. She was like, hey, what do you mean you wanna get rid of it? You want me to go get you? And I was just like, damn. So meaning like, but I do a lot of shit off camera and I don't do it on camera because I don't wanna do it for the clout. And that's the thing, we feeding, bro. I done gave out so much shit homeless to homeless for shoes. I'm talking about, I wore White Forces one time and give them away. Like, so it's like, and I got about 50 pair. So it's just like, I'm not bragging about this shit, but I think the more weight I take on, God be like, that's like.
That's big. I never looked at it like that. It's almost like taking on the tedious task. In class, niggas been wanting to do the hard part. Niggas want to do the easy shit. You the one to say, give me the hard part, I'll give me the hard part. The hardest part of it, I'll do it.
And that's what kills me too, so it's a given a curse, because my backbone be weak as fuck some days. Like, damn, bro, I can't do this thing. And then right when I do that, it's like,
I can't explain it, bro. It's something that is just like some manifestation shit or some shit.
And like a voice in my head, like the manifest shit on Netflix. Like a voice in my head that pop in, like, do it. Hurry up, just get it done. Don't complain. And then I be having favors from people that I don't even know. Because I helped this person out, but it really helped that person out. And that person helped, you know, shared it with that person. So
right.
I be having like connections I ain't even know yet. You know what I mean?
That type of shit.
I get on the phone. Cool. Hey, call this number. Okay. All right, hey, this cross. Oh, what's up, man? I appreciate you for what you did. I'm like, man, what I did? Oh, but all
right. Right.
You know what I mean? Like,
right.
Yeah, bro.
Man. PZ World. So, first track.
Yeah. It's called PZ World.
Right, it's actually called PZ World.
Yeah.
But the introduction, the whole thing of PZ World, man.
Yeah.
Vegas Jungle Stories, man. Go hard.
Yeah.
That's hard right there. Third track is With That Being Said.
That being said.
Reminder. You can actually play this motherfucker from 1 to all the way through to 12. It seemed like it's more than 12 songs.
Yeah.
Because of how much?
How many times somebody might play it back?
And the substance in it.
Okay.
It got a lot of. You got gumbo in this bitch.
My dog.
Nah, for real. Cause it's like, some songs were just simple playing, and you know how you when you got an extra oomph in it, it's like you could tell you put a lot into this shit, bro. Like a lot of emotion behind this because you could just tell. I've heard other albums, bro, but you ain't. It seemed like you know how to rap better on this one.
No, because what it was, I ain't gonna lie. I got bored with. I wouldn't even, and this is the honest to God truth. I was doing some music, because every time I dropped a tape, I took somebody's situation. I don't know what it was. As soon as I drop an album, the bitches go crazy. And it's like, oh, you call somebody outside tonight? And you know, we politicking out, baby. Look, hit me when you feel me. You, woo, woo.
Right.
Show hit me. Album come out, motherfucker got about 5'10 from me. So it's like, I started just make music. If you go listen to it, you can hear that it's just, I'm in my own world, for real.
Yeah.
Like, I'm talking about nothing but ism.
Right.
No pain in my music. Money ism,
right.
Money ism.
Right.
You know, a little bit of gang culture, because I am still from where I'm from. And then it's just like, but this one, PZ, I'm representing somebody's name, bro. Like, I can't. Do what the hell I want to do.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Nah.
God forbid, I you know, something happened to me, but then one of my mans or something put out a tape, and it's like...
That show a lot, though, bro.
Gotta be able to...
This album show a different side of you, because it's almost like you saying, it's still your world, but it's Peasy's world.
It's Peasy world.
You feel me? So it's like a DJ Drama said, it's like almost like a formality.
Yeah.
It has to be done like this.
Yeah.
And I think...
Yeah.
The whole thing with this album, it's gonna bust open the doors, bro.
Hey, you know what's so crazy? And I'ma say this like this, like, I'ma say it like this because this shit got me more, like, mind you, I ain't even really promoted it yet. Like, I have it on all the blog sites. I haven't even did a promo run for it yet. Literally, not one, and it's like, damn, how the fuck is people fucking with it like that? Like, you know what I'm saying?
I mean, one thing I can say, I don't know how long you've been doing it, but you've been telling us PZ World is coming.
Since October last year.
Yeah, you've been warning us. You've been telling us that PZ World is coming. You have.
Yeah. Because initially when I was going to put it out, I didn't, it was too violent. Like, it was, and that wasn't the type of relationship I had with PZ. So initially it was me talking crazy.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, damn, that wasn't me and his relationship, and that wasn't who he was. It's a savage for shit show, but it was more so like when we linked up, the nigga was on some, let's politic, let's go see some bitches, let's go, you know what I mean? Hey, Cross, turn off that bullshit, I don't wanna hear that rap. I wanna hear you snap. He like when I snap, and say real shit. My situation is like when I rap about this money and shit. They like, yeah, talk for us. Cause we, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like, speak for us, nigga. Like, you feel me? Let these hoes know they can't fuck with us. You feel me?
Right.
This shit was too trill.
Yeah, no, real shit. I heard Monroe Flo say some shit. He said, a nigga, we 22. I'm shooting on my age group. That nigga only 22.
Yeah.
Nigga, You 31.
Yeah.
You shitting on your age group. You outworking your peers.
Yeah.
You feel me? It's like, I would say too, nigga, where is the competition? I'm getting bored with this shit.
I got bored.
Like,
listen,
you know what I mean? Like, it's nigga, lonely at the top. I be like, nigga, flash, nigga, it's lonely at the top. You know what I mean?
Niggas don't even know I'm removing my tattoos right now. I done been to 2 laser sessions already. I got about 10 to do. Like, bro, don't let me remove my tattoos. I'm getting my teeth done. I'm about to go to Maldives at the end of this month.
Okay.
That's in Asia. Wow. It's my bitch's birthday. I'm gonna take y'all to Maldives. Y'all niggas don't let me do all of this reconstructing and still don't catch up, man. See, and this is the part of the nature of my competitiveness that's speaking. Yeah. This ain't got nothing to do about no money.
Right.
This is the music. Okay. You know what I'm saying? Because niggas always get bags. Like, Vegas, one thing about the city, niggas gonna get some bags. Whether it's big or little, gonna be all right.
Bags.
So it ain't about that.
Yeah.
I'm talking about the music. Right now, I'm under construction.
Yeah.
Next time y'all see me in about a year from now, I'm gonna have different tattoos and videos. They gonna be like, look at this video. He got these tattoos. Look at that one.
Hey, so,
they better not let me do this, bro.
Hey, honestly, so, do you like shit talking, though?
I do. I do, bro.
Yeah.
I like the... Only reason why I like shit talking... It's because I know niggas don't fuck with me.
Right.
But when niggas see me, they fake fuck with me.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
Don't fake fuck with me, gang. Like if you see me, it's just like, oh man, I ain't speaking to that nigga. That's cool.
Right.
But me, I don't fake fuck with you. I'm gonna tell you right now, I don't fuck with you. If you don't fuck with me, I don't fuck with you. I don't even got another reason why. You see what I'm saying? Just leave it at what it was. Cause most of the time, the shit don't be about shit anyway.
Right.
So yeah, I like talking shit.
Yeah. I mean, for all reasons, it's like when you just start saying that shit, it was just like, I saw the artist in you.
Yeah.
The artist in you, like, you know, and I think that's what we gotta have fun with. Yeah, you know what I mean? Like, really, like, have fun with it, like, you're an artist. Stop taking shit so serious.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because it's like, we all trying to create content to go viral.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? We all trying to do something that's like, make us stand out, or they like, man, I'm really this. Y'all should fuck with me. Or yeah. I'm really doing these interviews. I'm in a Maybach with D Cross. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But I really am, though.
Yeah.
We really is, though.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
You know what I'm saying? What I got
you
this
feel me, bro?
I should have bought a glass of champagne, man.
No, we really is, though. And that's the beauty of it, bro. Like,
nah, we really in a Maybach truck.
Man, the dude been the Code 7.
Yeah.
He been to room service radio,
yeah.
And you know what I'm saying? And the nigga, man, the Black King, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
The King salute, man.
Yes, sir.
The man out here bought me lunch. We out here on the strip, man, chopping it up. PZ World out.
PZ
just
World.
Dropped June 25th on my motherfucking birthday. Mm-hmm. So that's
classic. That's what's up.
That's classic,
that.
Man. Hell
that's
yeah.
Love. I'll forever good in your eyes.
Oh, God, wow. Man. PZ World, man. And not even just that, bro. Your jewelry be hidden, bro.
Oh, man. You know we ain't got to do no...
Yeah,
you know?
Nah, your shit real, though. Nah, bro,
yeah,
we ain't going to
Yeah, we ain't gonna do no Capriotis, man. I don't even like sandwiches, man.
You said no Capriotis, huh? Man, but it's just like...
Yeah.
Just the whole Vegas music scene. How do you feel about the Vegas music scene?
I love it. I think niggas is hearing the message of the cockiness and the arrogance for myself. Speaking on the music and really just being like, all right, nigga, I'm about to make some hot ass shit. I'm going to show this nigga. And that's what I want.
Right.
Because at this point, we know when it comes to the money, cars, clothes, hoes, that shit is like, it's no competition.
Right.
So therefore, let's speak about what we all in it for anyway, which is just the music.
Right.
So the music, like, just go make something hotter. And this the point that I'm trying to prove.
Your shit line up though.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like
you actually walk what you talk.
Oh yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That's the difference.
That's the difference
that's
too,
the
bro.
Difference,
like,
bro.
Niggas
you
be,
really walk that shit and you really live that shit, bro.
Bro, you know what it is? Niggas be on their music.
I said, this nigga got the motherfucking Maybach, man. Alright, when I seen you, I said, baby, this nigga got the Maybach, baby.
Yeah.
I said, this nigga, I really like showed it, went to your page. I said, this nigga really got that motherfucker.
Yeah.
But I was happy for you. I was thank like, you. And I've learned if you celebrate with others, you almost get it too.
I swear to God.
I'm happy for you.
Dog.
Like real shit.
That's
like,
one thing I was, when I'm on tour, like, or when I'm just moving around rappers, I watch a rapper homeboy or just a nigga from his city. Them niggas promote one nigga so hard because this is what happens. When they come to Vegas, the rappers, they should be able to say something like,
y'all know D Cross, y'all know P Fire, y'all know whoever it is. Bitch, yeah, that's my nigga.
Right.
Even if you don't know the nigga, bitch,
right.
I'm from Vegas, woo woo.
Right.
You might get what you gonna get out the bitch or whatever you trying to do off the strength of showing love. Because now I might bump a torch. You be like, oh, I was with your homeboy. He was showing me all your music. And I'm like,
right,
who?
Right.
Woofy blam blam. I'm like, I fuck with him now. Because he didn't have to do that.
Exactly.
The problem let me tell you niggas this. The problem is the reason why these niggas is losing when it comes to this hustling shit. These niggas hate so hard, the bitch gonna come look and see who it is. Then I ain't gonna lie.
Hey, y'all.
When she become a hooker, I mean a looker, yeah. I'm a tooker. I'm tooker, nigga. It's over.
My goodness.
The moment she, and then what happens is she go to the page, so she don't gonna say nothing the first rep. She just gonna chill and be like, oh, damn, okay, I see why he hate.
Right.
When y'all get in an argument, my DM is blew up, so now you become an op because all you could've did was show love. My bitches know, like, when I pull up, oh, that go bro, right? He go crazy.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, whether he getting money or not, like his music or like the way he do with his kids
or
he do interviews, he do podcasts.
Right.
I'm gonna always show that love.
Right.
Because it costs me nothing.
Nice.
That shit come back to haunt you when you hating on a nigga.
That's real, though. You ain't lying.
Stop hating on a nigga, bro.
Nah, real shit, bro. Just being in this game, what you say, how long you been doing music?
I've been doing music. I've been rapping since 13.
It's 13.
Yeah, I've been doing for real since about 24 or 25.
And don't that shit boggle your mind that it's like that the whole city don't know who you is?
No, they do. They do. Listen,
I'm talking about like the white folks, man, like Aliante area, Henderson.
But see, you know what though? No, it don't bother me because I ain't put that foot yet for yet. I still haven't.
Gotcha.
Cause I told you I don't want to be famous.
Right.
I just like having this shit popping out here and there and making my statement and popping back in the castle and stacking back up. Like,
right.
If I'm gonna get famous, it's not gonna be because I God honest truth, and this is what I'm telling y'all. It's not gonna be because I gave it 100%. I've never gave music 100%. I just like fucking with niggas and knowing niggas can't do what I can do.
Right.
Like, I'm not gonna sit in here and tell you I gave blood, sweat, and tears to music. That's cap.
Yeah.
I just got a couple dollars and money makes shit move, okay? Here goes some money. I want you to host this, DJ Drama.
Yeah.
I want Boosie, I want you to do this. Mozzie, I want you to do this. Davies, I want you to do this.
Right.
Joel Santana. And the list goes on. You know what I mean? So, money makes shit fun.
Right.
You know what I mean? And so, if I ever sit here and say I gave 110 on music, no, I haven't. I'm watching niggas struggle to give 110, it's like, fuck.
So what?
Like, if I did that, my nigga, I'm 9 out of 10.
Man,
time for sure I'll be
but
in this
you
bitch.
Know what? That's the real shit, man, bro.
I ain't gave music 110%. I don't want to be famous, bro. I like doing this. Right now, we sitting where we at. Right now. You heard what the valet nigga said. He said, man, I'm going to give you your key, man. Don't scratch no other car. You got the most expensive car out here.
Right.
I got my girl draw that right there. The G-Wagon.
The G-Wagon?
Yeah, she drive that same one. Same thing. If you got red guts on the inside, same shit.
Yeah.
21, that's a 21. Well, what I'm saying is, like, I get more fun off of just doing it, the music. Because I get more fun off of hustling like that. Them two right there? You see that?
Yeah.
You're going to have to crack the window, boy, and lean
okay.
in against it. You know,
man,
so the hustle is my thing. I really like the hustle, but the music, I just like being on top of the city, man. I ain't gonna lie.
We definitely on top, man.
That's like
I just pray, man. That's not even just pray, man. That's just like it's like if you hear something tight, I think you should burn that shit out. Blow that shit out until you don't like it no more.
Yeah.
Like Vegas jungle stories.
Yeah, I'm gonna shoot the video.
Niggas should play that shit all fucking day that's how it should be.
But you know what though? You know why that's not gonna happen? I'm telling you why it's not gonna happen. Because these niggas are looking at this shit, this Maybach shit, the trays, and they focus on that. Which makes they women focus on it. And you know, if your woman likes something you don't like, it's instant argument in the crib.
Right.
So if niggas just focus on, man, I go fuck Cross. Pull up.
Never cried
featuring Dave East over a million views.
Million views. I didn't even know it was over a million. Somebody told me. That's how much I don't pay attention. I didn't even know. It was over a million views 30 days before I knew.
That shit is crazy, bro.
No cap.
And it's like, how? I don't see it, bro.
Let me tell you how being organic works, bro. Game. Listen, watch this. My fuck niggas up. I play the video game. Listen. I play the video game. 2K, dog, demon. Mm-hmm. That's how I met the rapper, The Game. I whooped his ass. I lost to him, but I dropped hella points on him, whatever. He invited me to an Xbox Live party. I don't do no PlayStation. Nigga got me in the party, was like, you want to hoop? I'm like, this The Game, the rapper? He like, yeah, nigga. So I hooped with him for about 6 months. Never bring up music, nothing. I put something on WorldStar. This is 2017, 18. I put something on WorldStar. He said, Cross, nigga, this you? My name on Xbox is Poom. So he like, Poom, this you? I'm like, yeah. He's like, hey, nigga, you want to come on tour? Niggas think I pay for... Niggas just talk too much because they think they see me buy a lot of shit, so they just think I buy everything. I didn't do none of that. I didn't pay for no fucking tour. I just buy shit that I like. I went on tour, bro. Pay for my own flights, cause Game had booked me I went to Malmo. I think that's Denmark. I'm not sure. Malmo's in Denmark, but it's a 14-hour flight. He booked me a economy ticket. I said, no fucking way. I'm flying 14 hours around the world in a seat like this.
Right. He said, no fucking way.
No fucking way, my nigga. I went and got my passport. Watch this. I'm gonna tell you some true shit. I went and got my passport. I paid $11,000 for me and my little partner flight at the time. Flew up. Well, I spent $22,000 just to get there. No cap. $22,000 just to get there. I got there. You feel me? Woo wham. This one I was on Xanax. I ran out of Xanax. I told my bitch, get on a flight just to bring me Xanax. I paid another 11 grand for two more bitches to bring me some Xanax. I can't make this story up.
Because you gotta have it.
I gotta have the Xanax. This before I went to rehab.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know.
Man, that's big. You talking about, bro.
I was a fly junkie.
Wow.
I was a fly junkie. I was the highest nigga and the flyest nigga, man. Nigga didn't know.
Tell the truth and shame the devil.
Hello?
And you ain't got no shame in it.
No.
But it's the way it's coming off your tongue, though. And it's I feel you on it because it's like, ain't nobody got no hell or heaven to hell to put you in.
Saying louder for the motherfuckers in the back. Check it out.
No, you're paying your own bills.
I'm paying my own bills.
You don't know what the fuck you want to do. You ain't asking nobody for nothing.
I was, listen, so mind you, so 18, okay, and I'm just giving niggas a little backstory on me. So now 18, I go on tour. I spend $30,000 on tour. On top of, so mind you, I'm already 100 in just off of my own habits.
Right, right.
I'm like 100 in on my own habits in 2018. I come back home. 2019, I'm still on drugs. 2020, January, I had to go back on tour overseas. Okay. This time, I'm getting paid. Okay. See, this is what niggas don't understand. They got paid again, like retarded shit. I'm getting paid. I go and enroll myself. I had caught a break in the injury because I was trying to snap on my ex on some dumb shit. I'm still out. Yeah. I go, nigga, go to rehab. 14 days. I have to leave on the 29th to go on a tour. I get out of rehab on the 21st. I come back. I mean, it's 21 days. Excuse me. I go on tour. I'm tweaking. I'm on stage. The whole 21 y'all seeing me performing them videos that's on my page. I'm fainted out. Like, literally shaking and shit when I get back to the room. My bitch is wiping the sweat off my head, giving me water, and I'm withdrawn.
That's crazy, bro. Me and my girl was just in there saying, like, I don't see how people can even function off of Xanny bars, bro. That should have happened in the...
But see, it started because I got migraines. I suffered from migraines, so... But now, I'm good because I switched my diet and did a whole bunch of other shit, I suffered from migraines. I'm a natural growing up good kid. My mama didn't smoke, my brothers don't smoke or drink. Nobody, you feel me? So I got introduced to the Xanax because I was having the migraines. My partner said, man, take a little bit of this, man. I took that bitch, headache went away, but I fell asleep instantly.
Yeah.
I woke up the next day, I said, man, let me get a pack of them shits.
You said a pack of them.
5 years later, I was on Xanax for 5 years.
Damn. But able to function?
Yep. You said, ooh, studio with his cap ass, who that? Yeah, I was able to function. Studio with his cap ass, I don't know who that is. Anyway. Yeah, no, I wasn't able to function. No, I was able to function. Shit, you do anything for long enough, you're gonna be able to function.
Yeah.
You know
man.
What I'm saying? So, that's what I'm having.
So, after PZ World, you getting back to what kind of music?
I'm about to go party style now.
You figure your angle on how you coming?
Yeah. That's what I'm doing. This Do It Like Wayne, I'm about to drop. So, Do It Like Wayne, basically, I'm doing it like the dedication. I'm taking everybody beats, and I'm just snapping over. It ain't no substance or none of that. Just me gassing the whole time. Just saying whatever the fuck. You feel me? So that's really what I'm doing. And after the Do It Like Wayne, then we gonna go back to the shits. Go back to the like the Peace World vibe.
Gotcha.
Yes, sir.
I just can't wrap my head around that the Vegas music scene ain't bigger than what it is. Niggas still kind of hating.
Yeah.
Not even just that, bro. Is that like you got to tell them? Because I try to tell them for myself that if you don't put in the work, you ain't gonna get no results.
Nah, hell no.
You know what I mean? If you don't put in any work, that's with anything, and especially with music. Especially with music. I mean,
niggas don't want to spend their money. Listen, this is what it is.
That's it, right?
When you spend your money, niggas say, oh, he paying for everything. When you're not, a nigga tell you, man, you gotta put that money to the music. You can't win for losing. So it's like, how you wanna do it? Me, I just spent $25,000 to go to the Maldives at the end of the month. Like, that's what I wanna do though.
Right.
And I'm about to take another 20 before I leave and give it to the promo for the music in Atlanta.
Right.
I gotta go to Atlanta, LA, do some promo. And I just applied for my verification yesterday. So, you know, niggas is just moving and trying to figure it out. But I'm here to live how the fuck I want to live.
Are you with Empire or are you just strictly independent?
I'm not with Empire. I'm distributed through Empire.
Okay.
I got a deal on the table. Well, this was 2019. We ain't revisited this conversation since then. But
yeah.
I know guys.
Yeah.
Good dude, solid nigga. But it's just like when niggas trying to offer, niggas is already getting that. So it's all like... Right.
You trying to give me $500 and I got $500.
No, I take $500. I ain't gonna lie. Yeah. It's just more so like if I'm a son, for the less it gotta be for the more. Put me in the front.
Yeah.
Cause I know I'm out working.
Right.
You know, they got a big roster over here.
Yeah, they do.
I need to be immediately signed, sealed, and put me in the front and I'll take less.
Yeah.
Or give me more
and
then we'll work on me when we get to me.
Nah, I feel you. I like the way you think, man. Nah, for real though, because you a businessman.
Yeah.
You're a real businessman and you're a mogul at that. You know what I'm saying? And it's like, if anybody been watching you, Instagram, Facebook, it's like you always kicking real shit, bro. You ain't never telling, I never hear you talk bad on anybody. I never hear you saying shit that's gonna make a nigga hate. It's like you just living your life.
That's it, bro.
Yeah, real shit. I mean, I call myself the boss too if I'm doing what the fuck I want to do. And
that's
it.
That's all it is. A boss is not because of what you got. You can do what the fuck you want to do. And people make it try to twist the narrative like a boss is take care of the grown men. I'm not taking care of not a grown fucking man in the world.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying? And right. I've done that. And that shit left me in debacles and fake beef and fake smoke. Like,
niggas off that.
If you a grown ass man and you can move how you want to move, that's a boss. Because I'll tell you what right now, I know a nigga with not even a half of what I got, a third of what I got, and happier than me.
Right.
All he do is go smoke his little weed, go get his little bottle, chill with wife and the kids every night. Best lifestyle I ever seen as far as when it comes to inner peace.
This shit
ain't inner peace. That's why when I get to barking on niggas sometime,
it be
from some whole other shit. They don't even be about what I'm saying. You know what I'm saying? Like, gay, that should be for some whole other shit that happened 2 months ago.
Right. I feel you.
It ain't never for nobody in particular.
Yeah.
You feel me?
So, as far as the competition.
Yeah.
Niggas ain't got you in the car. Niggas ain't got you in the jury.
Yeah.
And we talk about rappers out here in Vegas.
Yeah.
Real shit.
is there anybody that you feel that even though they ain't got you in the cars, yeah, the jewelry, the money,
yeah,
is there anybody that feel like they got a slight edge, or like, damn, I like that about him, you know what I mean?
Ooh, yes,
that
yes.
You ain't told.
Yeah, I like a lot of, first of all, it's a lot of people. Okay, it depends on what we judging it off of. We judging it off of the catalog? No, I don't think it's one person.
Okay.
The longevity? No. The obstacle I had to take? See, nowadays, all you got to do is make a song. When I was starting to rap, we had to go against Landlord and Young Ballers. We dissed them niggas.
They dissed
us back.
Right.
And that shit almost went to some real gunplay.
Right.
Going to school, niggas was active, so it was like, the obstacle I had to take. Now you can make a song and your homie like it, and the Cold 7 interview you right. five days later. Like,
right.
That shit is not the same route.
Right.
You know what I mean? So, but if we just talking about off bars and shit, yes, a lot of niggas that I feel like, damn, this nigga's cold as fuck.
Right.
You know what I mean? So, yeah, I, as far as the music, I just feel as if how I get past niggas, okay, if the bars ain't gonna do it, if you ain't gonna, which I feel like I'm very horrific, I call it horrific because I'm terrific with the bars,
yeah,
so we say horrific.
right.
I feel like I'm horrific with the bar.
Right.
Okay, fuck it. If they ain't gonna listen to me, then we'll get drama. I'm gonna do a cheat code.
There you go. Straight
so now, right now, no.
Yeah.
No, drama's on my tape. Shut up. Yeah. Who y'all talking about?
Right.
No, nigga. Yeah, yeah. You lose already.
Hey, Soulja Boy is the first rapper first rapper from Vegas with DJ Drama.
With DJ Drama, right? In the Maybach truck. What's up, right? The Maybach truck.
I say this nigga would have got a DJ Drama.
Yeah.
Hey, but guess what? If you can afford it, you can afford it.
Why not? And I'm going to tell you what, but
at the end of the day, too, though, it's all about still trying to get our names outside of Las Vegas. That's the biggest marketing scheme I've seen anybody do this year. You did that.
Yeah.
You went and got DJ Drama. That's the biggest shit that any artist done so far through the year.
Yeah.
Hell Gang Hitty signing with Mozzie.
Yeah, and you know what? I like Hell Gang. I like Hell Gang. And watch this. If go watch interviews, watch this. This is the coldest part about the shit. Go watch all Cold 7 interviews. When they get to the rapper part, nobody says my name. It's like two rappers that do that. They go over me or under me and act like I don't exist. Just pay attention to what I'm telling you. I'm gonna tell you who I like. And I don't give a fuck, because it ain't gonna make or break me. I'm going, when I get out this interview with you, I'm going to go pick up 10K. Yeah. And not off no EDD. No SBA, no government shit.
Right.
I like Landlord. I like Pool Pistols. I like Lil Sox. I like James West. I might be missing a lot of niggas because I haven't heard them.
Yeah.
So let's make that clear too.
P-Fire.
Shout out to Fire, the Taylor Gang, and the Coke Boy. They in the battle to get him right now.
Okay.
So he doing shit. I like a lot of niggas. Watch this. When your board time broke, just go, man, let me go see if Cross was lying or not. Go look at these rappers. They don't say my name. So.
You know what?
Watch.
I watched that shit too, and I haven't heard it.
They won't say my, bro, they don't say, they be acting like, oh, I fuck with, this nigga, cause now you don't like me because what I'm doing is not obtainable to you.
Right.
Which it very is. This shit is all in the reach.
Yeah, but
niggas don't like me for that.
Yeah.
Nigga, my own people's like,
man, not when you know they can take your fucking bitch.
But this the thing. The type of bitches niggas fuck with couldn't even sit in the car with me, bro. Like that'd be the
shit.
Like what? Nigga, you fighting over that?
Right.
Ew. And it's not about the look, it's just about what is she doing.
Right.
Cause I'll put a motherfucking wig on the pig and watch a jig, man. That ain't got nothing to do with
talk about it, man. You know, for real, say that away.
But it's gotta, what is she doing? Like, I don't have no smoke with niggas and they will not say my name. Go back to Cold 7. Go, and somebody brought it up to me. Cross, these niggas never say your name in these interviews. So who you fucking with in the city right now?
Man.
I mean, I fuck with they gonna Landlord for sure, because Landlord start to be more humble.
Right.
When Landlord was on his pretty boy long hair shit, they couldn't stand it.
Keep that shit real.
when Landlord was on this young baller, real young baller, like hair swagging, knocking bitch, they didn't say nothing. They don't ever say his name. They don't say my name because of whatever reason, But I promise him it's never because of anything I did to the person.
I should just be over the bitch, though.
It be over the bitch, bro. Over the bitch. It's the city we in.
It is. And in Vegas, it's like our whole community thing. Like, we get down to, say it's a club going on, or a lounge, or whatever, or just a function. We, before the end of the night, we start people watching. We all just looking at each other.
Yeah.
We all just looking at each other, seeing how many people shake your hand. They go cross right there, and they're watching your diamonds all fucking night in your chain. They're going to stare at you all night because of you got that on there, and they're going to think you got the better hand because what you got on every day.
Nigga might have just, a wise man told me, man, you dress your best when you're at your worst, man. So don't matter if I got this shit on or not, I might be doing terrible. But I'm out here to you know, from, I'm on a mission when I'm outside.
Right.
Like, meaning this, and let me just say this. In Vegas, if we stop trying to push this savage-ass culture, we not really, we gonna handle our own business, but we not known for savagery, man. Yeah. We known for getting money, dog.
Real shit.
Think about it. We got $34 billion buildings on one block. Why the fuck I wanna sit here and talk about my Glock all day?
Right.
Who the fuck gonna believe that? Right. That's why I was saying when Cali niggas in our city like blood, you ain't no crip. Yeah. Why you think they feel like that?
Right.
It's a $1 billion block.
Right. Niggas, y'all about money, y'all soft, y'all about getting money.
Even if that's what they think, you can be your own man.
Right.
You might be with all that shit, but come get some money. Because that's what we known for, and it's okay.
Nah, you're right.
Chicago known for killing, so they stuck in that terrible-ass mindset.
That's a good-ass point. You're
like,
right.
Like, do what you know.
L.A. known for banging.
L.A. known for banging.
Vegas known for money.
Vegas known for some
get
money.
Get some motherfucking money, man.
Get Vegas known to get some motherfucking money, dog.
Nah, real shit. And you look,
Bop.
Man, you make us look good, man.
You know
nigga.
What I'm saying? That's what I'm saying.
Gonna
like,
lie, nigga. When you go out of town, nigga, you the motherfucking Aria, nigga.
Hey.
When you say, where you from? You say Vegas.
Yeah.
Nigga, Aria.
That's
man.
Cool.
See your ass.
They get some money.
This nigga light that motherfucking city up, nigga.
That's what I'm saying. Like, if we all come together on the same mindset, see, niggas all talk right. about, oh, well, we need to squash the beefs that we having out here.
Right,
dog,
right.
It ain't really no too savage shit going on in the city, man.
Nah,
really it's got niggas, it's niggas that still doing shit. I ain't shitting on the city. But let's go for what we know.
Nah,
really
if
we all push out to this strip with 100 Vegas t-shirts on or 2,000, everybody in the same night from Vegas get a Dre's tape. Think about that. If we all went and everybody pitched in on to buy the whole dance floor to Dre's, and we all wear the same cheap t-shirt.
Right.
Oh my God. Vegas in this, it could say Vegas in here or something.
Nah, you're right. That's gonna, but every tourist in the motherfucking house is gonna go back and tell every place. You're gonna touch every 50 states. You're gonna touch the 50 states by doing that. Because there's somebody here from every fucking state.
Nigga, them Vegas niggas was in there. They all had the Vegas t-shirts and what the hell. And then, you know, the DJ like, who in there? What side in here?
I didn't even know Vegas had niggas like that.
Bro, because when you in the club, they say like this. Do I got Cali in the building? They scream.
Right.
Do I got Atlanta in the building?
Right.
They never, even in Vegas, they don't say, do we got Vegas in the building?
Right.
And that's our fault.
Right.
Get what I'm saying? Because we'd rather stay in our little huts and neighborhoods instead of come outside. It's a $1 billion block, brother. Right. Brody, I'm telling you.
Yeah, now you're right. You're
when I first started to come out this bitch for real, leaving the north, I came and said, no motherfucking way. This is, look at this shit. I was woke, 16.
Yeah.
I fell into the fast life. I said, oh shit, look at that. Damn, she just did that for 30 minutes?
Right.
No. No.
Turns you out.
No. It won't be me, nigga. I won't be the nigga now getting it out this bitch.
You feel me?
And that's what all I want. So if we thinking about coming together, let's come together on this strip.
Right.
All right. Let's all walk in the Dre's. Let's all go to After Hours Dre's. Let's go in the Floyd Club. Let's go to.
Yeah. Nah, real shit.
You know what I mean?
Yeah,
if we got 100 people, and that's doable. That's really doable. If we got 100 people, we all break down a table. Nigga, you looking at $40 a piece.
Right.
Them tables ain't nothing but $3,000-$4,000.
You're right.
Everybody pitch in 50, 60.
I swear to God, everybody wear the same shirt. Nigga.
I'm with that.
Same hat. Nah, real shit, me too. Cause that's gonna break the chain. It's starting to trend, it's starting unity. And a nigga bringing the people together. A lot of people's like, don't get me wrong, bro.
It's like, I thank God for Cold Savage. I thank God for Hip Hop with Lou, because they're bringing other elements to what we need.
Exactly.
For the Vegas music scene.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? Because of them doing Cold Savage and Hip Hot Seat with Icy Jones, because if you did that already, I said, man, you know what? My shit got to be different with Big Cross. You know what I'm saying?
Make busy.
I said, man, I got to let me get the interview in the Maybach, man.
Yeah.
Because I'm going to play this motherfucker back. I'm going to go back, put this motherfucker on YouTube. I'm gonna make some clips out of these motherfuckers, yeah, man. Everything, the whole experience. But it's even just walking, spending the day with you, man. The last 2 hours, nigga, we've been here since 2:30, 2:45, you know what I'm saying?
We've been here.
Yeah, really just sitting here chopping it up. Ain't thinking about nothing else going on in the city right now, but the wholesome fact that we here, yeah, and shit, motherfucking Peasy World is out,
Peasy,
man.
Peasy World is out. Man. And you know what? I'm trying to get better on, because my whole lane was, people feel like they didn't know what goes on in the mind of me, because every time they heard me, I'm just talking about material shit. So I'm getting better opening up. It was like something I never wanted to do. But I like to do it with your energy. Like when you hopped out the car, you was on live, I was on a live with you on the way. I'm like,
right.
Man, let me get up and be fucking with me.
Right.
And it's such a refresh. People think that it's dope to hang out with me. I'd be happy to hang out with people from the city that's doing something.
That type of shit.
I love it.
Nah, real shit.
I don't give a fuck how much money you got, what you don't got, bro.
Oh, God, bro. This is my second time having an encounter with you.
Yeah, I call same it, way.
This was an encounter. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Because we really sitting down here, we eating.
Yep.
And we get down to the business part of it. Because the business part of it is that Peasy World is out. Y'all need to stream that.
Peasy World
right now.
Roll
that shit up.
Bow.
Put Vegas Jungle Stories on your feet.
that's nigga shit.
Now, go to sleep to that shit. Nigga. Yeah. Blow that shit up so nigga we can get so somebody can say that Vegas got music.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? We all know it here in the city, but it's like in the same way, we need a Snoop Dogg. We need a T.I.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
It, that's what I'm saying. It's room for everybody.
Real shit.
But when I'm telling you, I've seen it firsthand, dog. I've watched it from
you anchored, bro. You got your own spot, bro. From like you say, certain niggas ain't gonna fuck with you because you already beat them in areas, bro.
That right. I wouldn't even race them in. That's
exactly,
the crazy part.
Exactly. You already beat them in certain areas.
Yeah.
So it's like, it ain't a cheat code. It's just like, I got a single out right now featuring Filthy Rich.
Yeah.
I paid $11,000 for the song in the video.
It's fire though.
Right. I'm not even on it. They just say Charles Tatum, but the whole thing is that it's to get our name outside of Las Vegas. I'm gonna use whatever I can around it to make that shit look bigger than what it is.
That's what you're supposed to do, bro.
You feel me? I paid him an extra $1,000 to put it on his YouTube channel because I know I don't have more subscribers than him. I want this shit to blow up. I'm at 41,000 views on the video already in 3 months. You feel me? So it's not doing bad at all.
That's solid.
You feel me?
Especially for an artist, for you not having it on there as your shit.
Right.
Like you put it on, you put the play together.
Yeah.
Solid. And that's what I'm saying. See, bro, it just takes a certain type of nigga to understand that.
And I still got my own shit to push, but at the end of the day, I know that and nigga, if this nigga shit work,
hell yeah,
then shit, fuck it too. Fuck it. I wanna go with what's hot. I wanna go with a cheat code at. I wanna be with somebody that's actually gonna make this shit really know how to make this shit happen. Yeah. Because nigga, you got your name attached to DJ Drama.
Yep, that's crazy. I can't even. And he got to listen. You know what's so crazy? Because I dropped first, and then Tyler the Creator dropped. That shit is number one. He got number one album. Now he working with Bliss and Beano, the nigga from LA.
Yeah.
Or Blast, whatever his name is. But I'm in that circuit of all of that.
All
right. The DJ Drum. So when if a nigga type in DJ Drum, and I'm in a circle with Wayne, because Wayne, niggas don't know he working on some shit with Wayne. Okay. Working on some shit with Meek.
Right.
I'm gonna be in that circuit.
Right.
If you gonna put in DJ Drama right now, I'll pop up.
Right. Exactly.
Nah,
real shit.
I had to spend money. I think I gave Drama 15. People would have thought I gave him 40. Hello.
That type of shit, bro.
You know what I'm saying? But and when he said 15, I said like that.
Man.
I say, damn, I got that on me right now. That's all he wants.
You feel me?
I thought he was gonna say 30, man. I would've been like,
everybody's tapping in, man. Cross the boss, man.
Yeah, man.
Sir Charles Tatum, man. We up now, not next, not later, but right motherfucking now, man.
Hey, y'all shout out to my boy Means. Happy birthday, King. We outside tonight.
Y'all already know what it is, man. D motherfucking Cross the boss.
My dog.
Peasy World out, man. Whole album hot fire, man. Go stream that shit. Run it up. Don't be a hater all your motherfucking life,
please,
nigga. Please don't be a hater all your life, man.
man. The dude got real credentials, man. The dude is a native from Las Vegas.
Yes, sir.
He's a real live motherfucking player, man. And they motherfucking stacking paper, man. And at the end of the day, it's about getting some money.
If you
ain't doing nothing, you better get some money around this motherfucker.
Hey, man, if you're from Vegas, man, and you ain't been down to the... If you say, man, I don't like going to the strip, you done lost your mind already, bro. I'm just going to leave it at that. Hey, man, if it's $34 billion... buildings, you can't get $100 a day out this motherfucker, you might as well just claim somewhere else.
$34 billion buildings.
And you can't get $100, you might as well just go ahead. Damn, look a baby right there.
See, I don't know how y'all living on this great Friday, man, but I'm with the boss man himself, man.
Oh, man, likewise.
Man, Peasy World. Man, thank you for welcoming me to Peasy World, man. Yeah, on some real shit, man. Can't nobody say nothing bad to you about you to me. Appreciate because I'm not gonna see that.
And I don't want problems with nobody.
Y'all heard what he said. He don't want no problems.
I don't want no problems with nobody. You know what I'm saying? I don't have any problems with nobody. So anything somebody say about me, bro, they made it up. Or call me. Cross, this nigga said he did that. What's his name? If I had to ask you, if you tell me his name and I go, who is that? Just say, all right, bro, have a good day. I'm gonna call you that. He don't know who the fuck you is, bro. Why you just picking with that man?
Facts.
Niggas just be liking to pick with me, man. Pick with the inch, man.
This man has really, really been... I kind of hate it scoring. They got an end, you know?
Yeah.
Because
it don't got to, man.
Nah, you motherfucking right. It don't. You know what, people? Man, what you got going on tonight?
Hey, how y'all doing? Just having a little dinner back here.
Yeah, man, I'm some boss shit. Man, this nigga, I'm chilling with the boss right now, man.
Nice dog.
Yeah, I'm in the PZ world right now.
In the
back of the Maybach.
He's pretty cute. I mean, I'm...
Yeah. What we doing tonight is, if y'all would come out and have a good time, we're going to go to Embassy tonight around 11 for my boy's birthday. I really don't do Embassy. It's not my type of scene, but it ain't always about me. You know what I'm saying? And I can appreciate having a good time with some good people, man. So if y'all ain't doing shit, pull up tonight. Come have a good time. And Peasy World is out. And Peasy World will be being played in the club. Vegas. Yeah, fuck it. I might do a giveaway, Vegas. Come on, man. Pull up. You know I'm in a good mood, man.
Man, real shit,
just pull up.
Man, he is in a good mood. This nigga bought me some food. This nigga bought me Fiji water, nigga. Everything. I'm talking about, nigga. Got a nigga feeling like I'm rich in this motherfucking shit.
Oh, man, we are. Hey, rich is not material. It's in the spirit, man.
I'm already a little bougie, but this nigga done help me out a little bit now, man.
Oh, man, you can control the air back here. You see if it's too cold, too hot, that you can change the motherfucking... Matter of fact, you take the bitch out, man.
Man, look at this.
You know what I'm saying? If you wanted to just get a massage, change the lights, close the windows, sunblocks, we can close everything. Let's go this way first. Oh yes.
You know. Nigga, the first rapper, nigga, from Vegas, nigga, like on some Soulja Boy shit, nigga. Nigga gotta start Soulja Boy.
Niggas gotta start
Soulja
Boy.
Oh God, nigga. Nigga, give me my motherfucking flowers, my nigga.
Thank you, brother. Thank you.
Give this man his flowers, man. This nigga doing this shit, man. Peasy World out.
Peasy World out. Please go stream it. I'm doing interviews and everything for the world too, because I get a lot of feature prices. For the city right now, man, for the next week, I'm doing everything free. I'm just trying to show love and show it back. Because I get my own tour coming up in January. Shout out Game for helping me for the last two. I got my own coming up. I'm about 7 countries in. And then I'm working my way back onto the U.S. Territory. And I'm going to be at House of Blues.
House of Blues.
House of Blues is okayed me to do a show too. So.
Dog.
Peasy World, man.
Man, PZ World is out streaming on all platforms, man.
Yo, yo, yo.
Cross the Boss.
The Bezos, man.
The first rapper to do an interview from his Maybach truck.
From the Maybach truck, man.
You know what I mean?
First nigga in the
city. I'm the first nigga radio host to interview a nigga in the Maybach truck.
Yeah.
Cole 7, what up?
That's my dog. Shout out my hustlers, man.
I fucks with y'all. Y'all know what it do, but man.
He got it live from the Bizak, man.
From the Maybach, man.
That way.
I did it, man. I beat y'all with this one, man. Real shit. No
hey,
cap.
You know what's crazy, too? Because I was doing $1,000 Thursdays. And shout out to them for, you know, to understand it. Like, they was like, hey, yeah, we used to fuck with $1,000 Thursdays. Why you stop? And I was like, should I stop? Because I ain't, you know, I'm as a rapper, it's hard to manage other rappers as far as they flow and shit. Mm. So, you know, even with that, just inspiring niggas to want to fuck with the city a little bit harder, like they said I did. Mm-hmm. I respect you for that, because they ain't have to say that either with Cold Sense.
No, facts.
And you've been doing your shit for a long time, so everybody's inspiring everybody.
No, real shit, bro.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
keep the shit up. Okay, yeah. We outside tonight. Pop out, man. It's Friday in the city, man. If y'all see that Maybach bouncing, it's all good, man. Just wait, man. That shit straight, man. Yeah. Yeah. She got a wagon back there.
Uh-huh.
Love seat.
I love seat. Jones. Yeah. Hey, Icy Jones. What it do, man?
Tonight, man.
Icy Jones. Peasy World is out.
Peasy World.
Peasy World is out, Icy Jones. Man, it's streaming on all platforms, man.
Shout out my boy.
This nigga done hit a grand slam. He done hit first base, second base, third base. Man, he done made it on home, man.
Come on, man. Let's do it.
Man, actually, man, I wish I could, we gonna get that radio interview, but I love this exclusive interview, man. From the Maybach, we done ate lunch. We done
chopped
it up.
I can't wait to see how this bitch look.
Man, on me, we done chopped it up. We done ate. Man, you a real nigga, man. Real shit. You ain't have to do none of this shit today, bro. They could have been busy. Like, nah, fuck that shit, man. I'm coming to the
I owe you a verse, and I feel I'm. Listen, most niggas talk shit. You just kept it cold, calm, political, and you understood the mission. And that's what it's like. That's why it's good to fuck with niggas older, because it's like niggas understand life a little bit more.
Right.
You know
real shit, bro. Hell yeah,
when you dealing with, when you trying to do business with a nigga who don't really understand business or just life, that shit get kind of tough. Nigga want you to move right now.
Yeah, nah, hell nah.
Can't do that.
Not when you got a life.
But watch this verse. It's over with. Man, you know I'm in my bag, right?
Yeah, this shit is the go, man.
My dog. We about to flick it up.
Oh God.
We gonna see y'all tonight.
Oh, real shit, man.
Appreciate you, King.
Yes, sir, man. 100, man.
I need this flick.
Already.
I'ma lead this up so y'all can watch it on my.